This is a production of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, made possible by the Friends of SDPB. Pledge your support for quality programming. Call Friends at 800-333-0789 or donate online at sdpb.org. You may purchase this video and many others online at our website. Click on Shop SDPB. And thank you.
This high school activities championship event is conducted under the auspices of the South Dakota High School Activities Association.
AA Girls Volleyball Tournament, day one here at the Corn Palace. Two teams have advanced to the semifinals. Who will they face later on in the tournament? We shall find out tonight. Getting set for our evening session. Our first matchup is Rapid City Stevens taking on Huron. My name's Steve Toom. I'm joined by Levi Ludens and Trevor Schmidt, along with Jacob Van Bergen. This young man from Sioux Falls Roosevelt High School helping us out with our webcast here. Gentlemen, you guys did a great job this afternoon. Looking forward to the matchup tonight. Let's first quickly recap what we saw earlier today. Top-seeded Sioux Falls O'Gorman advanced past Rapid City Central, 3-0. And then in another matchup, the 4 and 5 seed, the 4th and 5th ranked teams in the final poll, Aberdeen Central and Sioux Falls Washington, squared off. And it was a dandy. It went 3-0 to Aberdeen Central, but it went 25-23, 25-23, and 27-25. Guys, you couldn't have asked for much better action than that second one, close all the way.
Yeah, very even teams faced off against each other, and close all the way around. I mean, even though it was 3-0, it was a very close 3-0 game, and the score really didn't show much for set-wise.
Yeah, both teams provided high energy and got our tournament off, started on a good note, and I'm glad that it's going to continue here in the second half, as both of these teams and both matchups are looking like they'll be pretty good tonight, too.
Yep, there you see the results for our earlier one. O'Gorman did struggle in that second set. Rapid City Central made it a contest, but just too many mistakes by the Cobblers, and O'Gorman proving why they are the top seed. They've only lost once all year. Who did they lose to? A team we'll see later on tonight. Sioux Falls Roosevelt, the second seed, takes on Watertown. But let's examine the teams that we've got coming up right now. Huron, the number 3 seed. They were number 3 in the final poll, taking on Rapid City Stevens. They come in as the number 6 seed. They were receiving votes in the final poll. These teams met once this year. It was late in the season, and it was Huron winning 3-0. That was 25-17, 25-21, and 25-22. So pretty competitive.
Yeah, very competitive. I think both these teams, I think it's going to be a different outcome tonight. I think Stevens is ready to go. They're fired up. They're going to be looking to make this a game, and I think they're very even as well.
Yeah, both teams on the year have 18 wins. It's just that Rapid City Stevens has played many more games with a total record of 18-11, and Huron only at 18-4. So both teams have really looked good and have a number of wins. So it'll be interesting to see that.
Yeah, you look at Rapid City Stevens played far more matches throughout the season than the Huron Tigers. When you look at their records and their seed point totals, Rapid City Stevens at 20-11, so that's 31 matches. Huron 18-4, only 22, so a longer grind of a season for Rapid City Stevens. Let's examine the Raiders lineup, and their two main players to watch will be Skylar Larson and Taylor Molstad.
Yeah, Skylar Larson leading stats all the way around with 40 aces, 291 kills, and 414 digs. Definitely going to be a key player for Stevens tonight.
And their main assist person is Sydney Daney. She'll be wearing number 4 tonight, 726 assists coming into the tournament. She'll be the person setting up the big hitters for the Raiders.
Yeah, and I'm sure they'll like to keep that chemistry between her and Larson tonight. Larson's been excellent, it appears, from her stats, and I'm sure that'll be one matchup to watch there as they try and set the ball to each other.
Kelsey Hendrickson, third on the team with 143 kills. Hendrickson at 5'11". Skylar Larson goes at 5'9", and she's a senior. Molstad, she is listed at 5'10", and a junior. Now let's examine the Huron Tigers, the number three seed, and it all begins with their two big hitters, Asia King and Haley Alderdings.
Yeah, King with 242 kills and Alderdings with 234 kills. Both very good weapons, and they're definitely going to use those two girls tonight.
They are set up by Kelly McCarty, the senior setter. 639 assists on the season for that young lady.
Looking down at the stat sheet here, and Huron spreads the ball around. I mean, they've got two people over 200 kills, both King and Alderdings, within 8 kills of each other, as well as two other ones over 100 kills on the year, so they like to spread the ball around.
And think about that. They've racked up those stats with 10 less matches, so that just shows you how dominant those players have been throughout the course of the season. Of course, Shelley Buddenhagen, the head coach for the Tigers. She's married to Tim Buddenhagen, the basketball coach over there in Rapid City. Stevens, they are coached by Josh Lean. This is the third matchup of the day here on South Dakota Public's Broadcasting's SDPB.org. We will have tournament coverage throughout the AA tournament here on the web, leading up to our coverage on television on Saturday night. That'll be on SDPB3 television. Our television coverage on Saturday night will be the third place and then the championship matches, plus all the awards ceremonies. And that'll begin at 6 o'clock Central, 5 o'clock Mountain Time on Saturday night. And don't forget, you can follow along with all the tournaments at sdpb.org. We got a moment here. Let's sneak a peek at the other tournaments, at the Class A tournament. That's being played up in Aberdeen. It was Belle Fouche winning 3-0 over Sioux Valley, and then Winner knocks off perennial powerhouse Wagner 3-1. So Belle Fouche and Winner advance to the semis at the A tournament in Aberdeen. And over at the B tournament, that's being played at the Huron Arena. No surprise, top-seeded Warner over Harriet Selby area 3-0. And Alcester Hudson beats Harding County 3-0. So Warner trying to repeat as champions. They'll take on Alcester Hudson. And there you see the matchups tonight. Those matchups also being webcast at sdpb.org. We're ready for the introduction of the starting lineups. We're going to send it over now to our public address announcers, Trisha Negebauer and Dave Brooks.
Good evening and welcome to the World Joni Corn Palace. The South Dakota High School Activities Association and its member schools, along with its corporate partners, Sanford Health, First Premier Bank, Premier Bank Card, Farmers Union Insurance Agency, Billion Automotive, and the South Dakota Army National Guard, are pleased to welcome you to the second session of the 2013 Class AA State High School Volleyball Tournament. Much too often, we are exposed to the examples of poor sportsmanship. That is why the South Dakota High School Activities Association is sponsoring a statewide effort to promote good sportsmanship in our schools. You can be part of this effort by displaying good sportsmanship during this state volleyball tournament. And now, let's meet the participants in this evening's contest. First, the Rapid City Stevens Raiders. Number one, Natalia Bracewell. Number five, Corey Nye. Number six, Leslie Karsrud. Number seven, Sydney Bodensteiner. Number eight, Marissa Herkett. Number 12, Taylor Molstead. Number 15, Nikki Quinn. Number 16, Andrea Hawks. And number 17, Brooke Bennett. And now here's the starters for the Raiders. Number two, Sarah Hast. Number three, Madison Larson. Number four, Sydney Daney. Number nine, Kelsey Hendrickson. Number 11, Skylar Larson. Number 13, Jenna Carlson. And number 20, Cassidy Steele. The assistant coaches, Janelle Jeske, Emily Frost, Carrie Beyer, Amy Sakura, Cheryl Mills, and the head coach, Josh Lee. And now, here's the players from the Huron Tigers. Number four, Hannah Nelson. Number seven, Lizzie Potts. Number eight, Sarah Carr. Number 11, Taylor Flannery. Number 12, Cameron Schroeder. Number 14, Sarah Skorheim. Number 15, Kenzie Glanzer. Number 23, Carissa Schroeder. And now here's your starter for the Tigers. Number 1, Haley Allerdings. Number 5, Lexi Ekman. Number 6, Bailey Rothgen. Number 9, Samantha Zell. Number 13, JC Huck. Number 16, Asia King. And number 24, Kelly McCarty. The assistant coaches, Kelly Henrich, Tim Neihardt, Samantha Reek, and Taylor Stemke. The head coach for the Tigers, Shelley Buddenhagen. The officials for this evening's contest, the R1 is Julie Ortman, R2 Kelly Devine, line judge Dave Bestie, and Jana Nolmans. Ladies and gentlemen, will you please stand as we honor the flag of our country with the singing of our national anthem. The national anthem will be sung by Mitchell High School senior Joel Morgan. We would remind all in attendance that the proper respect is to remove your hat, face the flag, and stand at attention with your right hand over your heart. Veterans and active duty military not in uniform may salute the flag.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming. And the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Let's play volleyball. And we are ready to go. The Raiders of Rapid City Stevens, the Tigers of Huron. This, the Class AA Volleyball Tournament at SDPB.org. I'm Steve Toon along with Levi Lutens and Trevor Schmidt. Again, these teams just met once during the regular season. It was late in the season. Huron won that matchup. But tonight, a lot more at stake, gentlemen.
Yeah, definitely. Even though it's a 3-6 matchup, I think this whole tournament, there's very even teams. I think all eight teams are very competitive, even the 1-8. O'Gorman did take that, but Central was very, very competitive.
Yeah, I'm sure that'll be one of the key things we'll talk about tonight. Very competitive matchups, and I'm sure we'll see some close sets and matches here coming down in the second half of today.
Yeah, because if you can't get fired up for a state tournament, you got to ask yourself, why are you here in the first place? And of course, Rapid City Stevens and Huron have had great programs over the last several years. Very accomplished coaches for both teams. This ought to be a dandy. Tigers will be dressed in their white uniforms. The Raiders in the blue uniforms. The Libros will have white for the Raiders and the dark uniform for the Tigers. And Huron will start things off.
Back to serve tonight for Huron, number 24. Kelly McCarty will serve over the first one. And her serve will go off. Number 2, Rafferty Stevens, Sarah Haas, goes off her arms and down for the first point. Huron ball up 1-0. McCarty back to serve again. The lefty will serve this one over. Big slam there by number 9 of the Raiders. That's Kelsey Hendrickson.
Tigers will set up their offense now. We'll get that one number five and number three for Stevens. That's Madison Larson with the dig. And Asia King's strike will go out of bounds just long. Second point of the night goes to Stevens, their first. And back to serve now for Stevens is number nine, Kelsey Hendrickson. Excellent serve there. And number 11, Skyler Larson of Rapid City Stevens will have her spike blocked. Back onto her own side and down for a Huron point, leading 2-1 now. Number 13 for Huron. That's JC Huck with the serve. And they'll say that one is tipped off of the Stevens defender. And Asia King, number 16 for Huron, will tip that one down.
Asia, 5'9 and a senior, led the team with 242 kills in the regular season.
And number 13, that's JC Hupp again, back serve. Tip over by Rapid Stevens with Florida's number 20, Cassidy Steele, with the nice tip over there for another Rapid City Stevens point. And they'll bring it back within 1 point now, trailing 2-3.
Yep, number five, Corey Nye, checking in for the Raiders.
And Sydney Daney, the server for Rapid City Stevens here, as she'll serve that over. And now we'll go into the net, point to Huron. Asia King back for Huron now. And her jump serve will be handled excellently by the Raiders. And they're gonna call a lift against the Huron Tigers. That's number 13, JC Help.
Substitution number 12 coming in for the Raiders, Taylor Molstad. She's second on the team with 209 kills.
And now on number 11, Skylar Larson serves. And they're going to call in the net against Huron. Point to Rapid City Stevens there.
I think they caught Samantha Zell, number 9, in the net for the Tigers.
And Larson serves again for Rapid City. That one will fall in for a point there. Excellent setup and a nice kill.
We've got a sub in for the Tigers, number 7, Lizzie Cox, a 5'6 senior.
And she is back to serve for the Tigers. Her serve is handled by a diving Raider defender and fell just into the net, back under their own side. Point goes to Huron as Cox will be back to serve again for the Tigers. And it'll be handled by Larson of the Raiders. That was number 9 for Huron. Samantha Zell there with a nice tip over and kill for Huron, putting them up 7-4.
Nice little run here by Huron.
And Cotts will take that one again. McCarty sets this one out to number 1. That was Haley Alderdings. They're going to call a lift against Huron, point to Rapid City Stevens.
As we've seen earlier in the two games earlier, you cannot let Huron go on a little run here. We've seen too many teams fall because they've let the opposing team just get on these 5-6 point runs.
Alderdings tips that one over. They'll set that one to Skylar Larson of the Raiders. Alderdings with a nice spike there, but dug out. That would be by Daney, the setter for Rapid City. And Samantha Zell, her spike will go out of bounds. Point to Rapid City Stevens. Number 3, Madison Larson will serve for Stevens. And a tip over by McCarty will fall down for a Huron point now. Good awareness there by McCarty to tip that one over. Put that one down hard, and it was just too fast for any of the defenders to get to. And Alderings will serve. The setup was for number five. That was Corey Nye. But her shot would be blocked back onto the Rapid City Stevens side. Point to Huron.
I think it was J.C. Hupp, number 13, who was the key blocker there for the Tigers.
Hupp only 5'8", but got up on that one to get the block. And that one will be tipped out of bounds off of the Huron defender. Point to Rapid City Stevens. Number 13, Jenna Carlson, in to serve for Rapid City. And her serve there was diving down in front of a defender for Huron. Excellent serve. And that brings Rapid City Stevens within 1 point of Huron. Carlson will serve again. This one to the libero for Huron. That's number six, Bailey Rathgen. Gonna be tipped. Point to Huron. That was, the refs will say that one was tipped off the Rapid City Stevens defender.
Also, that point goes for the Tigers. Coach Josh Lean asking for an explanation from the official.
Daly sent that one to number 12. That was Molstad. And Asia King will put that one over down in front of number 13, Jenna Carlson of the Raiders. Point to Huron.
A couple of times the Raiders have found that spot right in the middle of the floor. It's been undefended by the Raiders.
And that was number 9 for Rapid City, Kelsey Hendrickson. And her spike went out of bounds. Point to Huron again. It's number 4, Nelson, serving for the Tigers. McCarty will set this one up. Number 13, J.C. Hupp with the spike. And McCarty to King. Doesn't quite go down, but excellent job there by the Raider defense to keep that one alive. And the Huron defense makes a nice save there.
What a save there by 3 diving Tigers, and they're going to get that point. And Stevens is going to call a timeout.
Excellent hard work there. Pays off for the Tigers. They were diving around for that one. They got it over on their third and last attempt. And number 12, Taylor Molstad of the Rapid City Stevens Raiders, was not able to capitalize.
Excellent rally there by both teams. It goes to the Tigers. Hey, don't forget you can follow SDPB Sports on your mobile device. We're providing frequent updates to all the South Dakota High School events on Facebook and Twitter. Just look us up at SDPB Sports. Stay tuned along with Levi Lutens and Trevor Schmidt. Jacob Van Bergen will be part of our announced crew tonight. Brian Oakland will be joining us throughout the weekend as we make our way through 3 days of volleyball here at the Corn Palace. This is the Class AA tournament. Class A and Class B also happening as well. If you want to follow that action, just open up some more browsers on your windows there. Levi, go ahead and raise your hand. That's one of the gentlemen here. And then Trevor Schmidt, you can identify yourself. These young men from Roosevelt High School, of course, your team will be playing a little bit later on tonight against Watertown.
Hannah Nelson with the serve for Huron Tigers there. And McCarty will set this one. And that was number 13 for Huron. J.C. Hupp hit that one off a blocker for the Raiders. And down for a Huron point. Nelson back to serve again. The tip over by the Raiders was handled excellently. And Asia King will power that one home into the back corner. Point to Huron.
This is that run I was talking about earlier. We've seen in both games, the team that's won the set has really come out and made a nice run here, and this is not what Stevens wants, especially after that ace. Nice. Now they're down by eight.
Nice ace there by Hannah Nelson, as Levi just mentioned. And now Huron has doubled up Rapid City Stevens.
Isn't this about a seven-point run here for Huron?
I believe that is right. And that one will go out of bounds, ending that run for Huron. Rapid City, after that timeout, will look to gain some momentum here. So they'll make a substitution.
Yeah, it's number two, Sarah Hast, in for the Raiders. As we got to clean up a spot on the floor here on the other side of the court, as Samantha Zell will check out for Huron.
And the serve over by Rapid City. Asia King with a huge spike. And off the later, defender out of bounds. Another kill for King on the night.
Easy to see why she's one of the top players in the state.
Seen some great chemistry between her and her setter there. That would be Kelly McCarty, and she was the one serving there. Picks up that ace. She'll be back to serve again now after that last ace.
This is a huge run for Huron, and definitely a momentum booster as we're getting to the end of this set.
And Rapid City will tip that one over. Looks like number 11, Skylar Larson, with that tip over.
We have a sub in for the Raiders, number 20, Cassidy Steele.
And number 9, Kelsey Hendrickson, with the serve for Rapid City. As King and Spike will go out of bounds, point to Rapid City. Hendrickson will serve again for the Raiders. And McCarty will set that one up. That's number 1, Haley Alderdings, on the spike from the back row there. And Skylar Larson of the Rapid City Raiders will hit that one just long. Point to Huron.
Madison Larson, the libero, checks in. Number 3 for the Raiders, wearing the white jersey.
JC Hupp serving for Huron. Dug out by Skylar Larson. And they'll set her back up. And hers will be blocked. And King will take that one. And that'll be long. No defenders there in the area. And King might have just gotten a little greedy and pushed that a little bit too far out of bounds.
Number 5 checking in for the Raiders, Corey Nye.
And Sydney Daney back for the Raiders to serve. The setter will get a jump serve here. And McCarty tips that one back on her own side. As number 20 for Rapid City, that's Cassidy Steele. He just checked into the game, gets another kill for the Raiders. 19-13 here on lead here. Sydney Daney will serve again. Haley Alderdings with the spike. And Skylar Larson with the tip over. And Asia King's tip for the Tigers will travel out of bounds. And Stevens is starting to make a little run of their own here. Timeout. Huron trying to stop the run of the Rapid City Stevens Raiders. Only down by 5 now.
Hey, don't forget, on Sunday night, you can see Carol Burnett, the trailblazing comedian, receive the nation's top humor prize at the Kennedy Center for the Performing Arts. Top entertainers, including Julie Andrews, Tony Bennett, Tina Fey, Amy Poehler, and others, will perform in Burnett's honor as she receives the Mark Twain Prize for American Humor. That will be Sunday night at 7 Central, 6 Mountain Time on SDPB1 television. I got to ask you younger guys, you know who Carol Burnett is, don't you?
Nope.
No. Oh. Well, I could just say that growing up on back in the day, Saturday night was the Carol Burnett Show. That was one of the regular things you watched. Groundbreaking comedy with Tim Conway and Harvey Korman. I mean, that was, one of those things that seemed like everybody watched. Groundbreaking comedy from Carol Burnett. And it's great to see her honored with the Mark Twain Prize. You got some stats here for us, gentlemen?
We do. Rapid City Stevens' kill leader right now is Steele. She's got 2 assists. Daney's got 2, and aces Carlson's got 1. On the other side, Huron King's got 4 kills. McCarty's got 6 assists, and McCarty also has 2 aces.
McCarty will set that one up to King, and King will get her 5th kill on the night. off of a Raider defender. Huron comes storming out of that timeout. A big spike by Asia King, and she'll be back to serve now for the Tigers. And she'll jump serve this one. Had a little spin on that one as it dove down. And Haley Alderding's spike will go off of a blocker for the Stevens. And out of bounds, point to Huron. And King's serve will take a dive again. King will make a great save there for Huron. As Daly will tip that one over. And they'll call in the net against the Rapid City, or excuse me, against Huron. Point to the Raiders. Number 11, that's Skylar Larson, back to serve for Rapid City.
This is where Stevens really has to dig down and find that rally in him. Huron's got 21 points, so they're 4 points away from the set, and they really got to find that rally in him. And there's a block that'll start her off.
Lexi Ekman was the one getting set up there for the Tigers, and her spike was off a blocker's hand of Rapid City Stevens, and that one will send the ball back to the Stevens side again. Larson was the one that served that one over. And she'll dig that one out. Set up to number 5 for Stevens. That's Corey Nye. She gets a kill there. And Stevens is within 4. McCarty will set this one up to Alderdings. And off of number 3, that's Madison Larson of Rapid City Stevens.
Checking in for Huron, number 7, Lizzie Cox.
Senior Cott serves that one over. And Alderdings will tip that one back on to the Raiders side. Down for a Huron point. Now only 2 points away from taking the set here for Huron Tigers. Cott gets a running start and serves that one over. And Rapid City will get blocked on that one by, looks like McCarty for Huron. Nice big hit there by Rapid City Stevens. That was number 5, Corey Nye again. And Madison Larson back to serve for Rapid City. And Alderdings will hit that one over. And they'll say that one was down for a point to Huron. And we'll have set point here. Number 1, Haley Alderdings back to serve for the Huron Tigers, trying to end the set out. And Daly is set down up to number 9. That's Kelsey Hendrickson, who gets another kill on the night.
Jenna Carlson, number 13, checking in for the Raiders.
She'll be back to serve, trying to keep the hopes of taking this set alive for Rapid City Stevens. And Daly sets that one. That was number 12. That's Molstad for Rapid City Stevens. And they're going to call an inadvertent whistle, looks like, on the referee.
Well, I think they thought that the ball had crossed the line there and the whistle blew, and that was not the correct call, so they immediately reset things.
And that's number 13 for the Huron Tigers. J.C. Huff will hit it off her own net back under their own side. And Rapid City Stevens still alive. Number 13, Jenna Carlson serving still. McCarty will set this one up. It's number 9, Samantha Zell. Her spike will go out of bounds.
Rapid City Stevens only 3 points away from tying this game up. This would be a big rally if they can keep this going.
Party will set this one up, trying to put this one away. And Zell, a big spike, dug out extremely well by Rapid City Stevens. And Skylar Larson will hit that one over. And they're gonna call a lift against Huron. And that'll force Huron to call a timeout. Stevens has pulled within two now and has a chance to possibly catch up with Huron and even take this first set.
Don't forget to join South Dakota Public Broadcasting on Thanksgiving Day as we present some of our state's most talented young people. Tune in and experience the talent of South Dakota high school musicians and the All-State Chorus and Orchestra Grand Concert. We'll be rebroadcasting that at 1 Central, noon Mountain Time on Thanksgiving Day. And then at 3 o'clock Central, 2 Mountain Time, we'll present the Elementary Honor Choir. That'll be on SDPB1 television. Of course, the month of November started with the All-State Chorus and Orchestra Grand Concert. That was up in Sioux Falls. Began one of the busiest Novembers I can recall. Normally that's in late October, but just the way the weekends fell this year with the calendar, it seemed like everything got pushed back a little bit later, as of course Thanksgiving happening very late this year. And so we started off November with All-State Chorus and Orchestra. We moved into football and now into volleyball. Stevens still alive, walking the razor's edge here.
Jenna Carlson will serve this one over. And McCarty will tip it over. Dug out nicely by Carlson, but her dig was not a good setup to number four, Sydney Daney, who had to go diving on the floor for that one. And that'll be a point to Huron, taking the first set 25-22.
We'll have a break in the action here for a couple of minutes as Huron and Rapid City Stevens, they'll switch sides. Hey, we'd like to remind you that November is Native American Heritage Month. All month long, South Dakota Public Broadcasting will be presenting programming that outlines the American Indian experience. On Sunday afternoon, we'll present the program Sitting Bull, A Stone in My Heart. This award-winning documentary reviews the Lakota leader's life using his own words. That is on Sunday afternoon at 3 Central, 2 Mountain Time on SDPB1 television. And also part of American Heritage Month, you can see the independent lens documentary film Young Lakota. In that film, three young people living on the Pine Ridge Reservation try to forge a better future. This five-time Emmy Award-winning series, Independent Lens, is really like a film festival in your own living room. Each week, they bring you original documentary films made by the best independent filmmakers. On this upcoming Monday night, you will see Young Lakota. That is 9 Central, 8 Mountain Time, SDTV1 television. We got some stats here from the first set.
We do. Huron leads Rapid City Stevens in kills 16-6. They also lead him in assists 10-5, and also an ace is 4-1. So you can really tell after Huron taking that first set, when you're leading kills, assists, and aces, that's really going to help you, and that's really going to get you momentum. And I mean, with that much success, you expect it to continue throughout this night and tournament.
Yeah, I'm sure Huron's coach, Kelly Buttenhagen, will be telling our team, just keep it up and keep putting the pressure on Rapid City Stevens. Just to make note of the first game, Huron ended up beating Rapid City Stevens in three straight sets, so I'm sure Huron looks to try and do that again. And we'll see if the trend continues tonight, as both of the two earlier games, whoever had the most aces in the game or best serving overall has come out on top.
Get a look at some of the fans enjoying themselves here as the music's playing inside the Mitchell Corn Palace. Hey, we want to tell you about something that happened earlier today. There was a record-keeping error for substitutions during that Washington-Aberdeen Central matchup. We had a lengthy delay as the officials had to go back. They fixed it. They thought they had it fixed. Found out they were wrong. They had to fix it again, so we had a lengthy delay. But in the end, they finally got it right. It took a few minutes. During that very competitive matchup between Aberdeen Central and Sioux Falls, Washington, won by the Golden Eagles. They will face O'Gorman in our first semifinal tomorrow night. The winners here tonight, they'll form the other half of that bracket and the other semifinal. Our coverage tomorrow will begin at noon Central time here at SDPB.org with the consolation semifinals, the first matchup, Sioux Falls, Washington against Rapid City Central.
And the first set intermission is just wrapping up now. Both teams come back onto the court.
Great that you could join us here tonight at SDPB.org. My name's Steve Toom, along with Levi Lutens and Trevor Schmidt. We'll be joined by Jacob Van Bergen a little bit later on tonight. Ryan Oakland will join us throughout the weekend. as Huron makes the substitution for Bailey Rathjen. The libero, 5'6" sophomore, wears number 6.
If you're Rapid City Stevens, you really want to make an effort to win this set because you cannot go down 2 sets to this Huron team. We've seen it earlier today. If you go down 2, it doesn't really turn out very well. So they really need to focus on winning this set to tie back up at 1.
Sarah Haas will get this one started for Rapid City Stevens, and she'll be set to serve. The 5-foot senior will serve that one over. And McCarty will set this one up. That was number 13. That'd be J.C. Hupp of the Huron Tigers, and she'll hit that back on her own side. Point to Stevens. And Haas serve will go long out of bounds. Point to Huron. And Kelly McCarty will be back to serve for the Huron Tigers.
Number 5, Lexi Ekman, checking in for the Tigers.
McCarty with a nice serve as Daney will set this one up. That's number 9, Hendrickson, on the spike. And McCarty will set this one up. Asia King with the hit over the net. Falls in between number 3, Madison Larson, number 2, Sarah Haas of Rapid City Stevens. Another point to Huron as McCarty will be back to serve again. Excellent serve there off of libero. Madison Larson of Rapid City. 3-1 lead here early on for Huron. And Skylar Larson was able to get that one over on the third and final attempt. Asia King will hit that one off the top of the net. They'll set this one up to Skylar Larson, whose spike will fall just in front of a diving Huron defender. Rapid City Stevens will pick up their second point here in the second set. And Hendrickson's serve for Rapid City Stevens will fall into the net. Point back to Huron.
And Hendrickson checks out number 3, Madison Larson, in for the Raiders.
Number 13, J.C. Hupp, serving for Huron. And their serve will go out of bounds. Another point to Stevens. See if Stevens can capitalize on this couple of errors by Huron here early on in the second set.
Number 5, Corey Nye checks in now for Rapid City Stevens.
And Daney will get a running start and jump serve this one over. And down for an ace.
Oh, that had some wicked spin on it. Got over the net. Just like it dropped off the table.
Saw that earlier with Aberdeen Central's Brianna Kuzler doing that. See if Rapid City Stevens has the same thing going here against Huron. They're going to call in the net on Huron. Point to Rapid City Stevens.
Yeah, Stevens got a little bit of a break there as that spike was long from number 20, Cassidy Steele.
And Daney will serve this one again. That was number 1 for Huron. Hey Alderdings with a powerful spike that will travel out of bounds. And Rapid City Stevens has gone on their own little run here to go up 6-4 in the second set. Daney with the jump serve again, and that one will fall just off the hands of a Huron defender. As Asia King will spike that one over the net off of Raider hand and down for another Huron point.
Samantha Zell, number 9, checking in for Huron, replacing number 6, Bailey Rathjen.
Asia King will serve here. Dug out by Rapid City Stevens. And some miscommunication by the defense there. But Samantha Zell pushed that one over into wide open right side of the court on the Rapid City Stevens side. Point to Huron. Asia King serving again. Another return over the net on the first try there. And that one will be blocked. It's number 20, Cassidy Steele. Blocking that one back onto the Huron side. Point to Stevens.
Skylar Larson, the leader in aces, kills, and digs for Stevens, will serve this one over. McCarty will set this one up. That's number five, Lexi Ekman.
Out of bounds.
And they'll call out of bounds on Rapid City Stevens.
Number seven checking in for the Tigers, that's Lizzie Cox.
She'll do the serving here. And Danny will set this one up. It's number 12, Molstead. The down will fall out of bounds. Point to Huron. Cox back to serve again for the Tigers. Hard hit for her as Danny will set this one up. It's number 20, Steele. And she'll tip it over out of bounds, though. Another point to Huron. Timeout by Rapid City Stevens here, trying to stop this little Huron run.
And don't forget, you can learn the story of James Scotty Phillip, the man who saved the buffalo from his meager beginnings. The Scottish immigrant disdained the wanton slaughter of the American bison and set about to revive the buffalo. South Dakota Public Broadcasting is proud to present the world television premiere of the award-winning film, The Buffalo King. That will be coming your way on Monday, December the 9th at 8 o'clock Central, 7 Mountain Time on SDPB Television. That will be on SDPB1. Again, that is on December the 9th. Pretty even here in this second matchup. Huron, the slight lead, 9-7. Over the Raiders of Rapid City Stevens. Coming up a little bit later on, it'll be Sioux Falls Roosevelt taking on Watertown. O'Gorman and Aberdeen Central have already punched their tickets to the semifinals. We get a look at some of the Huron fans. Of course, they brought a huge contingent, not surprising. Only a short distance away.
And number seven, Cotts will serve down over to the Raiders. Cardi sets that one up. That was number nine. And that'd be Samantha Zell. That one fell in between a couple of Raider defenders. Point to Huron as Cotts will serve again.
Somehow they kept it alive.
Rapid City will set this one up again. And that's Steele with a nice tip over. Throwing that one over her head. And down in between all of the Huron defenders there. Another point for Stevens. Number three, Madison Larson with the serve for Rapid City. And she'll get the ace there as that one hit off a Huron defender's arms and under the net. Larson serving again. And McCarty will set this one up to Haley Alderdings. Some miscommunication on defense there, but Raiders were able to get it over, and the tip by Kelly McCarty will fall in between a couple Raiders defenders. Another point to Huron. And Haley Alderdings will be back serving for the Tigers. Danny sets this one to Skylar Larson. And that was number 13, JC Huff, whose spike went long for the Tigers.
Number 13, Jenna Carlson, checking in now for Rapid City Stevens, replacing Corey Nye.
Nelson serving here. And Davey will set this one up for the Raiders. That's Molstad. Excellent kill there for Rapid City Stevens. That evens this game up, 11-11.
Stevens made a nice little run to come back here, ties it up. And this could be an interesting finish here, even though we're only at 11.
Carlson will serve that one. And Zell has to get that over on the third attempt. Staney sets this one. That was number 13, Jenna Carlson. And a nice Nice kill there by J.C. Huff of the Huron Tigers, putting them back in the lead as number four, Hannah Nelson, will check in and be back to serve. Tigers serve that one over. And number nine, that would be Kelsey Hendrickson with a nice spiking kill right on the back line there.
Libro back in, number six, Bailey Rathchen for the Tigers.
And number two, Sarah Haas checks in for Rapid City Stevens and will do the serving here. The lefty serves that one over. So McCarty will set this one to Asia King. And Rapid City just has to throw that one back over the net. Another nice spike by Asia King. And that's 13 again. J.C. Huff, seems like she's been getting a lot of the targets by the center McCarty there, and she's been pretty effective tonight, putting a lot of balls away. As McCarty serves this one. And it's number 11 for Rapid City Central, Skylar Larson with the putback for the Raiders. And now McCarty sets this one up. That's Huff again, off a Raider defender's arms, and out of bounds. Another point to Huron.
J.C. Huff, 109 kills on the season coming into the tournament.
Kelly McCarty serves this one over. Diving Raider saves that one. And Skylar Larson will hit that one off of a blocker's arms for Huron. And Asia King will put that one down for a Huron point.
Timeout, Raiders.
Just going back to that last play, we've seen a lot of the better teams that have come out to win. They've done a great job of finding those holes where the defense isn't. I mean, with Huron, with O'Gorman, and with both teams, Washington and Aberdeen, they were able to find holes where the defense wasn't, make the smart play.
Don't forget, for complete stats, photos, and information about all the South Dakota High School Athletic Championships, you can find it online. Log on to sports.sdpb.org for complete coverage. Laura Dimmick here from our online staff taking some great photos. She's going to get them posted online soon. I'm just looking at them here as she's working on them. And Larry Rohr from our online staff was taking photos earlier today as well, and doing all the work that our online crew does. Some of the Watertown Arrows there observing. They are up next after the conclusion of this matchup between the Raiders and the Tigers. It will be Sioux Falls Roosevelt against Watertown.
And Kelly McCarty will be back serving again for Huron as they lead 15 to 12. Skylar Larson with the long spike there. And number five, Lexi Ekman's spike will go off a couple blockers for the Raiders. And Raiders will get a nice point there off an excellent block. And Kelsey Henderson serving for the Rapid City Stevens Raiders. And Danny will set this one up for Steele. He will tip that one down into a wide open hole there in the Huron defense. Close matchup here in the second set. 15-14 here in leading as Kelsey Henderson serves again for the Raiders. And Asia Steele's spike will travel just long. And we're tied up again as Henderson will be serving for Stevens. Powerful serve there, mishandled by number 13, J.C. Huff of the Tigers, and Stevens will take another lead. See if Henderson can match that one again. Going after Huff again on that one, but traveled just long and out of bounds. Point and ball back to Stevens.
Madison Larson checking in, number three for the Raiders.
Here's Huff serving for the Tigers. And they're going to call a lift against number 16, Asia King of the Tigers.
Corey Nye, number five, checking in for the Raiders.
And serving for the Raiders would be Sydney Daney, the setter. And McCarty will back set this one to Asia King. And Haley Alderdings will slam that one home for another Huron point. One of the top two kills leaders for the Huron Tigers. And Asia King, the leader for the Tigers, will hit that one into the net off her serve and will be substituted in. Bailey Rathgen in for Asia King now. It's number 11, Skylar Larson serving for Rapid City Stevens. Cardi sets that one up. It's number 5, Ekman for the Tigers. Now McCarty will set this one up. It's Haley Alderdings on the outside. They're going to call in the net. Against Rapid City Stevens there. Point goes to Huron.
Subs in for both teams. Brooke Bennett, number 17, checking in for the Raiders. Number 7, Lizzie Kotz checking in for the Tigers.
And Kotz will be the one back to serve for the Tigers here. She usually comes in just to serve and then is substituted out again. She gets a running start and her serve will go off the top of the net. And Daney will have to set this one up. It's number 12, Molstad. And her serve will be mishandled by the Tigers and falls for another kill for her on the night. Madison Larson serving. And her serve will travel into the net. Point to Huron. As Haley Alderdings will be back to serve for the Tigers. And a mishandled serve there by Rapid City Stevens. Sees the ball go back to Haley Alderdings. We'll be back to serve again for Huron. And Alderdings serve will travel out of bounds. Point to Rapid City Stevens. Tied up 20-20 here. Back and forth matchup here in the second set. Both teams got off to some early runs and have now gone back and forth, alternating points here.
It's definitely going to come down to who can finish this game, especially tied at 20. Who's got the fight in them to finish this set?
That was Huff with a nice spike there. And McCarty will tip it over on the return from the Raiders. Point to Huron.
It was a good dig by the Raiders. Unfortunately for them, it just got right up close to the net. And that's where McCarty saw her opportunity and she cashed in for the Tigers.
We've seen that a couple times tonight as Huron likes to slam over some powerful serves and Rapid City just has to force them back over the net because they're hit too hard. And Huff will hit that one down for a kill for Huron again. It's number 4, Hannah Nelson will be back serving for the Tigers.
Coach Lean wanted to call a timeout here. Everyone talking to their officials about something.
I think he wanted a timeout and he had none left, so he looked a little puzzled over there thinking he had one more, but he has used both so far.
Asia King with the tip there for Huron.
Coach Buttonhagen talking to the official and wants to check something on the scores table. Huron does have two timeouts. They're on the brink of going up big.
Hannah Nelson serving. Set point here in the second set. Huron already taking the first one. And McCarty will set that one up to Asia King. Long tip over will be handled by the Raiders. And Molstad will try and tip that one down. Dug out by the Tigers. And some missing communication there by the Raiders. Sees Huron's point fall down and they'll take the second set. 25-20 now leading two sets to none in this third quarterfinal matchup at the Mitchell Court Palace.
This is the Class AA Girls Volleyball Tournament for 2013. My goodness, what a fast this year gone. It has flown by. And we've had so many great tournaments going back to the winter months last year with wrestling, and then into basketball and track and field, moving into the fall with soccer and with football, now volleyball. And don't forget, you can purchase a DVD of any of the high school volleyball championship matches or any of the championship events that are broadcast by South Dakota Public Broadcasting. You can call 1-800-456-0766. Now, the DVDs are $19.95, plus $5 for shipping and handling. Now, if you're already a member of the Friends of South Dakota Public Broadcasting, the shipping is free. Now, for the volleyball tournament, your DVD will include all three matches from your team's appearance here at the state tournament. Again, the phone number to call is 1-800-456-0766, or you can log on online, sdpb.org, and order a copy of any of the state volleyball championship matches. You get a look at some of the fans here. Trying to recognize which team that was here.
Looked like O'Gorman.
I think you're right. I think that's the O'Gorman team having some fun here at the Corn Palace in Mitchell. Steve Toome along with Levi Lutens and Trevor Schmidt. Jacob Van Bergen will be joining us later on tonight. Brian Oakland will join our broadcast coverage throughout the weekend here at the Corn Palace. Things a little dicey out there weather-wise. Some snow rolling in this afternoon. When I got here this morning, it was starting to fall, and we've got about an inch or two of accumulated snow here. Now, the travel is just fine for the moment, and we certainly encourage you to come on out and attend in person if you can. But if you can't make it, we'll give you the best seat in the house right here at sdpb.org. You got some stats, gentlemen?
We do. Huron leading the way with 30 kills, 18 assists, and 6 aces. On the other side, Stevens, 12 kills, 9 assists, 4 aces. So quite a big margin there between Huron's kills and Rapsey Stevens' kills, and it's shown here tonight.
Yeah, definitely. Many of Rapsey Stevens' points have just come off Huron mistakes, and it seemed closer than it really should be, as Huron has been able to pretty much play the way they want to and have been fortunate to take the first two sets here in this quarterfinal matchup.
Yeah, definitely. Stevens has been in the game with Huron both sets. Just mistakes and miscommunications have really just doomed them in these past two sets. They really need to get that communication rolling. And I think they're just as good as team as Huron right now. It's just those mistakes and miscommunications.
And not only have those creep miscommunication mistakes, not only are they happening, but they're happening at bad times.
Yep.
For Rapid City Stevens. It seems to really, those mistakes have happened when it's really just crippled them and taken the wind out of their sails.
And the tip over by Steen will be handled by the Tiger defense. As Danny sets this one up, that was number 5, Corey Nye. This one out to Skylar Larson. Excellent defense by the Huron Tigers. And now it was number 20, Steele. Here's Davey. Excuse me. And that'll be number 12. That's Molstad. Taylor Molstad with the kill there for Rapid City Stevens. First point of this third set puts Rapid City Stevens up 1-0 over Huron.
Cassidy Steele out number 9. Hendrickson in for the Raiders.
And now Danny will set that one to Hendrickson as she tipped that one over. And Huron will set it up. So that was number 5, Ekman, who had to get that one over. And number 5, Nye. Kill left to the Stevens. We'll hit that one off of Huron defender and out of bounds. Kill for her there as Rapid City Stevens goes up 2-0. Number 3, Madison Larson, will be serving again. Cardi will set this one to Asia King. And her spike will be dug out. Taylor Molstad with the tip over there. As number five, Ekman with the tip. And they're gonna call number five, Corey Nye of Rapid City Stevens underneath the net there onto the Huron side. And Huron will get its first point of this third set. We'll be back to serve with number 13, JC Hupp. And Hupp will hit a short serve there. And they're gonna call in the net on number one, Haley Alderding for the Huron Tigers. Point goes to Rapid City Stevens again.
Jenna Carlson, number 13, in for the Raiders.
And she is serving now, and she was the one that was serving late in the first set as they went on a little run with her back there serving. But not this time, as Huron will get another kill.
There goes Asia King, who got that one. She'll serve.
Take a jump, and now we'll travel into the net. Possibly a costly error there by the Huron Tigers, as they'll send the ball back to Rapid City Stevens, who hopes to gain a little momentum on their side. Number two, Sarah Hast, serving. And the tip over will go off the pole on the right side of the net and out of bounds. Point to Huron there on the return. And Kotz will be in to serve now for the Tigers. And now Damien will set this one up as number nine, Hendrickson. And now Skylar Larson tips that one over and down between two diving Huron Tigers. Another kill there for Skylar Larson.
Cassidy Steele into the lineup for the Raiders.
Hendrickson with a nice serve. A bullet right at number six. That's Bailey Rapp, then the libero for the Huron Tigers team. Wasn't able to corral that one, as that one came speeding right off of her arms.
Seemed to have a little bit of a bend into it there. It kind of twisted a little bit before it got to Rapp, and that threw off her return.
And Steele with the tip over. Nice return by number 13. That's Hupp of the Tigers, but will travel just out of bounds. Good effort there by the Tigers trying to get that one in. Point will end up with Stevens, however. And Hendrickson will serve again. And a long serve by Hendrickson.
She's done that a couple of times where she's had a great serve and then she serves it long the next time around.
Trying to maybe put a little too much power on him. And now Alderding will serve for Huron. McCarty sets this one up. And that's number nine. That'd be Samantha Zell for the Huron Tigers, putting that one down. And Alderding will be back to serve again. And her serves in the net. Seen some mistakes here serving early in this third set. Haven't seen much of that in the first two sets. But
yeah, I noticed that the first two games, not too many serves into the net here, but we've seen quite a few more here with the Raiders and the Tigers. And speak of the devil.
Danny's serve goes right into the middle of the net and will send it back onto the Huron side now. It's number four, Hannah Nelson, checking in for the Tigers, and she'll do the serving here. And her serve will go over and Danny will set it up for the Stevens. Asia King with the long tip. And Nye with a big spike, but dug out nicely. And a big spike there. Asia King will put that one down for a kill.
King 5'9" and a senior for the Tigers. As we got the balls got away from one of the attendants along the sideline.
And Nelson will serve that one over again. And Steele with the nice tip, handled by the Tigers. And JC Hupp will hit that one out of bounds. Point to Huron. They'll call it off a tip on Stevens. Steven's thinking they're serving, and Huron thinks the same thing, so miscommunication here.
I'm not sure who's going to be serving.
They both have a ball.
I haven't yet to see the game where you have two balls in play, other than dodgeball, and that's certainly not the case here. We're at the AA Girls Volleyball Tournament. Huron and Rapid City Stevens matched up.
They'll give the point to Stevens, saying that was not tipped, and it'll just fall out of bounds. Stevens will be serving now.
Officials conferring at the scorers table here to make sure all the records are accurate. 9-7, Stevens.
This is Skylar Larson serving. McCarty with the tip, and that one finds space in Stevens' defense. Excellent job there by the setter, McCarty, for Huron, finding an open space and putting that one away. And their team will have the ball back now, and she'll be the one doing the serving for the Tigers. Nice serve there by McCarty. And they're going to give the point to Huron on that one.
Well, that was Asia King. Josh Lee now conferring with one of the officials right here in front of our broadcast location. 9-9, the Raiders and the Tigers all tied up. As we will get back to action momentarily.
I think Coach Lean for Rapid City Stevens is asking whether or not Asia King came across the net there onto the Rapid City Stevens side, which would have been a point to Stevens, but that was not the case, and Stevens will put that one away for a nice kill. And they'll take a 10-9 lead, getting the ball back with number three, Madison Larson, serving. And McCarty will set this one up to King, whose tip over was handled by number four. That's Sydney Daney of the Stevens Raiders. But that one will go out of bounds, point to Huron. And number 13, JC Huff, will be back to serve for the Huron Tigers. And Huff's serve will be sent back over the net on the return as the Tigers set this one up. And now Daney will set this one. Number five, that's Nye. And Asia King with another kill on the night for her off a couple of Stevens defenders' arms. Huron getting the ball back again.
Number 11, Skylar Larson, checking back in for the Raiders.
And Hupp will be the one back serving for the Tigers. Skylar Larson with a dig there for the Raiders. And that ball will travel off the fingertips of Asia King, set just a little bit high by Kelly McCarty, but worked out well for the Tigers. That one ended up going a little shorter than King wanted it to, but in front of a defender's arms for Rapid City Stevens. And that ball will fall off the net. Hard to interpret where it's going to go. And number four, Sydney Daney, had a little trouble with that one. Point to Huron.
Like we mentioned before, when Rapid City Stevens has made mistakes, they've come at the wrong time. And right there, Huron took a three-point lead, but that was a nice kill to come back after that mistake.
That was Taylor Molstad on that last kill.
Yeah, that was a big point there for the Raiders, because you fall down four or five at this point, you know, that really would have put Rapid City Stevens in a world of hurt.
And the tip by Allerdings will go out of bounds. Point to Rapid City Stevens again. Maybe they'll try and build a little momentum here and try and take this third set to keep them alive, as that's 13, Jenna Carlson doing the serving for them. Asia King with the tip over the net. And Taylor Moser has to hit that one. And we're going to travel out of bounds. Point to Huron. Asia King will be back to serve. High serve. And Allerding's spike will go off the net and out of bounds. Point to Rapid City Stevens.
Volstead out for the Raiders and checking in number two, Sarah Hast.
That last serve by King was an interesting one. It was really high, but it dove down at the last second.
And the backspin on the ball.
Skylar Larson will tip that one over. Deep into the Huron side, and the diving defender for the Tigers was not able to collect that one and go out of bounds. Point Stevens. And Allerding's spike will be hit down off of a blocker's arms for Stevens, fall onto the Stevens side, and down for a kill for Haley Allerding's. At number seven, Lizzie Potts back into the game. She'll do the serving. Danny sets this one to Skylar Larson, and her spike will go just out of bounds. Point to Huron.
Stevens was down by three. They tied it, and all of a sudden, nice two-point run here by Huron.
Nice serve there by Kotz. And now we'll fall for another Tiger point. And timeout to Josh Lean and the Rapid City Stevens Raiders. They'll try and collect themselves here in the huddle and hope to gain a little momentum coming out of the huddle as they trail 17-14 in the third set and trail two sets to nothing.
Yeah, those mistakes, they really came. They came at the wrong time. Once again, they were down. They had it tied, and then they had those three mistakes that really just killed them. Now they find themselves down by three.
Independent Lens coming up on Monday night on SDPB1 television. It's a documentary called The Young Lakota. The film follows three young people living on the Pine Ridge Reservation as they try to forge a better future. Independent Lens, it's a great series. Five times that series has won an Emmy Award. It's like having a film festival in your living room, and each week they bring you an original documentary film made by the best independent filmmakers working today. See Young Lakota, that is Monday night, 9 Central, 8 Mountain Time on SDPB1. Got some stats there, gentlemen?
Yeah, for Huron, some big stats coming here. King's got 14 kills on the night. McCarty's got 20 assists and also 3 aces for Stevens. Danny's got 11 assists to lead Stevens, and so this is gonna be coming out of a timeout here. Stevens really needs to fight forward and try to regain this lead, and that spike will really help him out.
It's at number 9, Kelsey Hendrickson was the one that put that one away for the Raiders, and she was doing the one serving now. McCarty will set this one up to Allerdings. And Cassidy Steele with the desperation spike over the net. McCarty will set this one up to Allerdings. And her short spike will fall just in front of the diving Jenna Carlson of the Raiders. Another point to Huron. Allerdings back to serve. Serve was to Skylar Larson there. It's Cassidy Steele with the tip over. Dug out by number 1, Allerdings.
Nice save there. Keep him alive.
Excellent diving save there. And the tip over by Samantha Zell will fall just short. Pins off the top of the net and back onto the Huron side. And number 4, Sydney Daney, serving for the Raiders. And her serve will go over the net. McCarty with the high set. That was number 13, Hupp. Skylar Larson's spike was blocked there. And McCarty, a nice tip. Caught the defenders off guard a little bit and fell right in between them. Another point to Huron, leading 19-16 now. Number four, Hannah Nelson, coming in to serve for the Tigers. And Asia King will try and get that one over. Cassidy Steele will tip it over for the Raiders now. And JC Hupp will hit it back for the Tigers. Skylar Larson will send it on to the Huron side, and McCarty will set this one up to King. And now that one will go out to Skylar Larson of the Raiders. McCarty had to put that one down. It was their third hit. And that one will go out of bounds. Point to Huron. Coach Lean of the Raiders wanted that one to be off of the tip. Not going to get the call as Hannah Nelson will be serving again.
And a timeout has been called by the Raiders. Don't forget to join South Dakota Public Broadcasting on Thanksgiving Day as we present some of our state's most talented young people. Tune in and experience the talent of South Dakota High School musicians. And the All-State Chorus and Orchestra Grand Concert will start at 1 Central, noon Mountain Time. And then at 3 o'clock Central, 2 Mountain Time, we'll present the Elementary Honor Choir. That'll be on SDPB 1 on Thanksgiving Day. We hope you can tune in for that. Coming up a little bit later on tonight here at SDPB.org, it's Roosevelt taking on Watertown. That'll be our last quarterfinal of the day. And then the semifinals will be tomorrow. The consolation semifinals start at noon Central time. Rapid City Central against Sioux Falls, Washington. And at nighttime, the championship semifinals at 6 Central, 5 Mountain Time. We already know one of the matchups. That's O'Gorman against Aberdeen Central. All the action here at SDPB.org leading into our television coverage Saturday night of third place in championship matches at 6 Central, 5 Mountain Time, SDPB 3 television.
Hardy will get that one to Asia King. And they'll fall down for a Huron point. So now Hannah Nelson will be serving for the Tigers, up by 5. Cassidy Steele with the tip over there. And Asia King will try and slam that one home. And will fall out of bounds. Point to Stevens. Huron fans did not like that one, but that one hit off the line judge, who was standing out of bounds. And Skylar Larson will be back to serve for the Raiders. Asia King with the tip over there. And Taylor Molstad will have to tip it back over for the Raiders. Number 13, Jesse Huff will put that spike into the corner for another kill for her on the night. Huron leads 22-17. Cardi was the one serving there for the Tigers. Steele with the tip. King with the tip back, and now Huron was on the ropes there as their defense is unable to corral that one. And we'll go back onto the Rapid City Stevens Raiders side with Madison Larson back to serve the libero for the Raiders. Cardi will set this one to King. And now it'll travel out of bounds. Point to Rapid City. Pulling within 3 now. And Huron will call a timeout, trying to stop this little momentum here by the Rapid City Stevens Raiders.
The holiday season means great music in South Dakota Public Broadcasting as programs you can't see anywhere else. See Barbara Streisand's Return to Brooklyn, Elton John in concert, plus regional favorites like Tonic Soulfaw's Holiday Special and the Hay Brothers Holiday Jam. That and a whole lot more coming up throughout the holiday season on SDPB television. I'm Steve Toome along with Levi Lutens, Trevor Schmidt, Jacob Van Bergen will be joining us a little bit later on. Don't forget, you can find out our television schedule where all those holiday specials will be happening online at sdpb.org, or you can check it out in the SDPB magazine. Great to have you with us in Metro tonight. Last year, this was the site of the Class B tournament. Now it's hosting the AA tournament here at the Corn Palace in Mitchell. And the community here of Mitchell has done they did a great job hosting last year, and so far the community has really rolled out the red carpet.
Excellent ace there by number 3, Madison Larson of the Raiders, to try and do it again here. Pull within one of the Tigers. And now Skylar Larson will have to hit that one from the back line. Tip over by Hupp there. That's number 5, Nye, and she'll hit that one into the net. Point to Huron. Huron leads 23-20 now, as J.C. Hupp will be back to serve for the Tigers.
Danger point here for Rapid City Stevens.
Cannot commit a mistake with only 23 points. They're going to try to get this one back in. What an effort there to keep that one alive.
Excellent job by Rapid City as they set it up now. Nice tip over there. Taylor Molstad will put that one off. A couple of Huron defenders. And down for Rapid City, Stevens point. Excellent hustle there by Rapid City Stevens, keeping that one alive and keeping their hopes alive, as number 13, Jenna Carlson, will be in to serve. Diving serve there, as that one will go to Asia King now. You hit that one over. Taylor Molstad will hit that one down for a kill for Rapid City Stevens. And this one's within 1 point. And Shelly Budenhagen will take another timeout for the Huron Tigers, trying to stop this Rapid City Stevens run. Pulled within 1 point of the Tigers.
SDPB Sports covers all the South Dakota High School Volleyball Championship matches. Right now, you're joining us online for tournament action from the Corn Palace in Mitchell. Also, we have online coverage from Huron in the Class B and Aberdeen in the Class A tournaments. And our television coverage will start Saturday night, 6 Central, 5 Mountain Time, from all 3 tournament sites. SDPB 1 will have the Class A in Aberdeen. SDPB 2 will be covering the Class B in Huron. Right here, we'll be on SDPB 3 television, and it'll be online as well. Make sure you tell all your friends and your neighbors the television coverage coming up on Saturday night on all 3 SDPB television channels.
And Carlson will be back to serve again for Rapid City Stevens. She's led a couple of late runs in this match, but that one will fall out of bounds. Huge point there for Huron, as they can now put the set and match away, as that is Asia King back to serve for the Tigers. Her jump serve will dive down and get down for an ace. And that'll end this match. Huron takes the last set 25-22. And for the third straight time tonight, we end in 3 straight matches. Huron taking this one 3-0, 25-22, 25-20, 25-22.
Another close matches. All 3 of them both teams got in the 20s on both times, so very close matches again.
All right, we're going to hopefully get a word here with Shelly Budenhagen, the head coach of the Tigers, in just a moment. Jacob Van Bergen standing by as soon as the players clear out here. And we get to Mr. Van Bergen in motion. We'll send it over to him. Jacob, you standing by with the coach?
Congratulations. I'm here with Shelly Budenhagen, the Huron head coach. Congratulations on the win first. And the first question is, what was one of the keys to tonight for you guys coming out with this win?
Well, I thought we came out and we were hoping to swing aggressively, and I thought we did that in the first 1.5 sets. And I thought our block got some touches on their heavy hitters, and we were able to slow them down a little bit and change their game. They started tipping more, and it took us a couple points there to adjust, but we were able to make the adjustment, and I thought our defense was key there, in there then picking up the tips and then getting us kind of in system and getting some good swings.
final question I'll have for you, and I'll let you go celebrate this victory, is what's one thing you're going to be looking for from your team in the next round to try to make it to the championship?
Well, whether it's Roosevelt or whether it's Watertown, right now we're going to try to treat every match as we have every season. No match is bigger than any other match that we played. And so I think we're just going to try to be ourselves and swing and play defense, because as any coach will tell you, defense will win championships. And so defense is going to be a key. If it ends up being Roosevelt, they're going to be taller, they're going to be a little bit stronger, but if we can get our block up and slow the ball down and let our defense chase it. And then if it's Watertown, they're a team that's getting really, really hot right now, and they're so fast and so quick. And so I think we just got to stay with who we are and see what happens and let the rest fall, I guess.
Thanks for the interview. Good luck, and have good luck going into the later rounds. Back to you guys.
All right, Jacob, thank you very much. Shelly Buddenhagen, one of the things you take about, I've seen her team compete over the years, the classic case of Shelly Buddenhagen, one of the great coaches, she always has her team ready at tournament time.
She certainly does, and we heard her mention how she liked her team came out swinging today, and they certainly did. Four big players for them really came out hitting the ball. They got Asia King and Haley Allerdinger, Allerdings back there hitting them, as well as Lexi Ekman and JC Huff. And so they were the ones really powering it down there for Huron.
Yeah, and also, I tell you what, Kelly McCarty played fantastic in this matchup for Huron as they will advance and they will face the winner of our next contest. That will be Roosevelt and Watertown. Let's check out the brackets as we have it here. Huron, they will advance and play either Roosevelt or Watertown. Now let's check out the brackets from the other tournament if we can. At Class A, Sioux Falls Christian playing Pine Ridge at the moment. We'll give you an update as soon as we get the information in there. You see the winners from earlier today, Belle Fushin winner, Dakota Valley and Sisseton. That'll be the later matchup there at Class A. Class B, that's up in Huron at the moment. Warner and Alcester Hudson advancing. Chester Area and Lyman are playing at the moment. And then the number two seed, last year's runner-up Arlington, they will take on Kimball White Lake. All the action from all three tournaments online at sdpb.org. Well, Huron has been victorious here. And at about 7:55 Central Time, they'll get the next matchup going here between Sioux Falls, Roosevelt, and Watertown. We'll take a break until then. Thank you to Levi and Trevor. You guys did great. Jacob as well. My name's Steve Toome. You're watching the Class AA Volleyball Tournament. We'll let you enjoy the sights and sounds here. This is South Dakota Public Broadcasting.